Well, I'm here at Fleet Feet with Stacie. Hi, Stacie.
Hey, how are you doing?
Good.
Good.
So, what do you do here?
Okay, so we fit shoes on people. So what we do is we do a gait analysis to figure out what the right kind of shoe is for someone when they're getting started in activity. And we watch what goes on with the feet to make sure that they're getting the right amount of support from the shoes and from the inserts. But the other thing that I do here is I coach training programs. So we help people get started in running and walking. So we work with people who are training for their first 5K on up to 10K, half marathon, marathon, and triathlon. So we see people from all walks of life who just want to get started in the sport that we love. So that's what I do.
So how long have you been running?
Gosh, a while. Running's been a big part of my life. So I started when I was in like 7th grade, and I'll turn 30 this year. So it's been a while. It's been a big part of my life. But sort of like we work with people just getting started in running. And for me, like swimming is as scary as running is for someone who's just getting started. So I think that I relate well to people who are just getting started in the sport because I know what it's like to just get started swimming. And it's scary and overwhelming and there's so much to think about. So we try to relate from right where people are coming from.
So what kind of advice do you have for someone who's overweight and out of shape and just trying to run?
Well, first, you have the most important thing already, and that's motivation and commitment. And that truly, like if you have that, you can really do it. The next piece is I tell people to like take it in baby steps. We hear people all the time come in and say, I tried to run a 5K, it didn't work, and we'll be like, well, what did you do? And they say, I mapped out this 3.1-mile course, and I tried it, and it didn't work. Well, and you can't. You really have to go step by step and be really gradual about it. So when we start training our very beginner 5Kers, so people who have not been active, we say it's couch potato to 5K. So we get them started with running and walking. So they run for a minute, but then they walk for three, and they keep doing that. Instead of saying, like, go out and run as long as you can, then walk when you need to and do it again, it's really structured. And I think having that structure is something that lends some comfort to people. So each week they start running a little bit more and they start walking a little bit less. So the first week they might run 1 minute, walk for three. The next week they run a minute and they only walk for two. And so each week we take a little bit of that walk break out and we add a little bit more running in and then gradually build up the distance as well. The first week is just a mile and then after 12 weeks they can do 3.5.
Okay, so how important is it to have the correct running shoe?
It's really crucial. So running, one of the best things about running is that you can do it anywhere and it's relatively inexpensive, but there is this one crucial piece of equipment and what goes on your feet. And so a lot of people get started and they don't pay attention to the shoes. They just think they're going to go out their door and give it a shot. And it's great that they have the motivation, but if they don't have the right equipment, unfortunately, they could end up hurt. And so the correct shoe means that it has the right support for you, the right cushioning, and that it truly is a high-quality running shoe. And there's all types of shoes out on the market, so getting the right one for you, that's what we do day in and day out with runners, with walkers, with people who just want to cheer on their kid at a football game. We get them in the right shoe.
Okay, one last question. What's your favorite thing about running?
Okay, my absolute favorite thing. There are a lot of things that I like about running. Like I like the time to be outside. I like the discipline it brings to my life, the structure it brings to my life. I know, just one thing. It's hard. My favorite thing is far and away the camaraderie. And I think of my best friends in life have been the people I've met running. And there's something about that time that you spend together pushing through some challenges is just so amazing. And so, like, my friends, like the only way we know how to catch up now is we do it on the run. And I go home to the high school athletes I coached years ago, and we don't even know how to go out to coffee together anymore. We're like, well, we're going to catch up. Let's do it on the run. So it's definitely the camaraderie and the friends I've made through it.
Oh, awesome. Well, thank you so much, Stacie, for agreeing to this interview.
Oh, no problem. So you need to, like, come and meet people who are running with us here. Come hang out with them, and then you'll have the same social group.
Cool. That sounds fun.
Sounds good. Yeah.